Good afternoon, everyone. This is your host, Devika Murlidharan. A warm welcome, one and all, to Beyond Glass Barriers 2020, the national workshop presented by IEEE Malabar subsection in association with Women in Engineering, which give you a golden opportunity to hear and interact with women personalities in leadership role for both professionals and students all under one shelter. The secret of getting ahead is starting. So let's start to enhance the real potential and excel in both career and family. So once again, I welcome each and every one of you to Beyond Glass Barrier 2020 Day 3. So as we move on to the first session of the day, I have a very important announcement to make. Audience, please feel free to drop your questions and doubts during the session in the Zoom chat box. We will be addressing your queries at the end of the session. So moving on, I'm very much honored to welcome you all to the first session of the day on the topic, Safeguard Yourself from Cyber Attacks. So without further delay, I would like to introduce you all to our speaker, Ms. Sri Lakshmi. She is an information security professional and a certified OSP, Offensive Security Certified Professional, currently settled in UAE. She has around 7 years of experience. She has been a speaker and have handled 50 plus sessions. She has been also a very active mentor for active cybersecurity community. So ma'am, it's our pleasure to have you here. On behalf of IEEE MSS, cordially welcome you to the session. Ma'am, please.
Thank you, Devika. Thank you, Bindima ma'am, and all the host of this session. Thank you so much for that warm welcome. So I'm sharing my screen. So I hope that it is visible for everyone here. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Devika, once again for handing over to me. I hope that we can start it. This is beginning with my topic, that is safeguard yourself from cyber attacks. It is like we all are in a dare for the, we are strongly fighting against Corona 2020, and we all are sitting in home and working from home, everyone, because in the previous years, if we think about maybe 1 year before, if we ask that whether the college has been happened online, we all say that no, it can't happen. The regular class should be gone with college. But all those thoughts has been changed. Everything has been made online today, as well as 20 years before, it was a thief who enters your home physically and take all your properties from the home. Now it's everything happens online. So everything is online today. So I must say that the good thing is also happening online, as well as the worst part is also happening online today. So so today I'll be dealing with a general thing about the cyber attacks and how it happens, and who are the victims, how the victims face, all these things we'll be dealing. But I have already told when I was approached for this talk that this is a vast, vast area which can't be taken in 1 or 2 days. I'm taking this only for 40 or 45 minutes. So I will be delivering in a general way. But I will be more happier to answer all the questions or concerns you will be facing, or I will clear all the doubts that will be shared with me at the end of the session. So starting. So myself, as Devika said, myself, I'm Sri Lakshmi Palil. So currently I am working as an information security professional in UAE with INJAZAT. It's a government organization which is doing VAPT for government subdomains. So I'm working there, and I'm half settled in UAE in Abu Dhabi. So currently I'm in Kerala. Kerala, right now I'm Kerala. Myself, I'm from Thrissur. So I have done my master's in cybersecurity itself. I'm not a cyber crime detection officer or like a cyber cell professional. I'm purely into technical session. I'm an ethical hacker. I can say that I'm an ethical hacker. I'm working as the same in Abu Dhabi. I'm a certified ethical hacker and then also OSCP, Offensive Security Certified Professional. And I'm right now an active mentor and a member of YAS community, that is yet another security, a cybersecurity community in Kerala with a bunch of students and passionate. Whoever is passionate about cybersecurity can join YAS community. So we are dealing with conferences and helping other people to grow up in this community. So I'm an active mentor of that. And I'm also, you all are hearing me, I'm a passionate speaker. And I would like to give back to my community, that is cybersecurity. So that's short and clear about me. So I think we can start. So what is cybercrime? Cybercrime is any crime that takes place online or primarily online. That is, the first part will be in online is also considered as a cybercrime. But after that, that attacks takes place in a physical way also. But it all started in an online way. Then also it is a cyber attack or can be concerned as a cyber attack. So cyber it is a part of cybercrime. It can be like a small data breach. It can start from a small data breach. That is even going like what we say, the small details you enter in the social media or in an online media, you give the details. The breach of that details also becomes a cybercrime. So a small data breach from the for the data breach that happened to LinkedIn. You may had heard that 2-3 years before a large data breach was happened to LinkedIn with all compromising all the usernames and passwords of LinkedIn. So that data breach to identity theft, that is like creating a, for example, I may have an Instagram account or a Facebook account, someone creating another fake account with the same identity of mine. That is the simple thing of identity theft. Even that becomes a cybercrime. That is also like what we say punishable, and our security law, information law has the to the punish that. So cybercrimes includes things like revenge porn, cyber stalking, harassment, bullying, child sexual exploitation. All these are the major parts that's happening in the cybercrimes. Nowadays, it is like building getting more popular, like, or more frequent, because I will say that out of 5 people, at least one of them will be a victim of one or another cyber attack in a smaller way or in a larger way or in a worse way. So everyone is like lane to attack. Everyone can be attacked today or tomorrow or in the coming days. Every one of us may become a victim. So cyber attack is becoming that common. And also we all know that cyber terrorism also becoming a major cyber crime. So that all becomes the cyber crime. So how do cyber attacks happen? Cyber attacks are usually executed through hijacking the traffic. Sure, when we are connecting to a public network, for example, we are connecting to a public Wi-Fi. Yes, you are prone to the cyber attack. Mobile attacks, if you are getting on, like if you are installing some applications which is not from the Play Store, you don't know the source of that application, you are installing that application or from the mobiles, or you are doing any other kind of like mobile verification, you are giving away the OTP or some other kinds of like mobile attacks. And as common, we all know, but still it is vigilant and vibrant attack that is happening day to day is phishing. Phishing emails, phishing sites, phishing attacks, maybe phishing apps, phishing QR codes, advanced QR codes. Advanced phishing attacks include the Word file, which is a normal Word file, which is attached with the like backdoor. So all these becomes a kind of phishing attacks, and it is too common till today. Even a lot of awareness is happening, even after a lot of classes has been taken, still phishing is a common attack and a successful attack. There are sometimes a blunder attack. I can say that blunder, DOS, because denial of service is that forcing. It is not to happening to an individual. A DOS is almost targeting a company or an organization to their server. It is like normally to a company. They will force or send the request continuously and they will deny that service, it will block that service and the server will crack, then it will give the access of all these things will happen. All the cyber attacks. So, but it is a blunder attack because almost all the servers are protecting themselves from denial of service these days. But again, this is what happened to Twitter, Reddit, and all these major organizations has faced the worst part of things due to this denial of service. Even if I say that there are a lot of attacks, but the thing is like, it is hard to identify the attack. Sometimes it is hard to attack. For example, an application that is downloaded and executed or run in an Android mobile or an iOS mobile or whichever. The thing is like, as soon as that application is run and executed, it will automatically disappear from the surface. So what it makes is it will make hard to identify that even any one of us will never identify that we are hacked or we are having a backdoor on our mobile or a laptop, we will never know. So it becomes hard to detect sometimes. I always said that even if there are so many other ways, phishing is the common way of attack. Because we cybersecurity people always say that there is a patch to all the vulnerabilities, but there is no patch for human error. The error or mistakes that are that we do, we can't patch that. Even if I patch myself, there will be one other person that will do. So phishing is still a common way. So what are the consequences of cyber attack? I have again generalized it. It is like economic, psychological, reputational, social, or societal. Economic, you may all heard that. I don't know, like everyone, maybe we may heard from at least one of us or one of us from our family may have faced the skimming of their ATM card or like getting their bank accounts attacked on their bank accounts. They have lost their money. They won't be able to get back that because social engineering here for all the attacks, social engineering takes place a major part. The attacker will be so good to convince anyone to jump into that attack or be part of that attack. Without triggering the victim directly from himself, no attacks is possible. That's the first thing. So they do their part. ATM card number, your CVV code. And they will say that this is blocked. So for unblocking, please tell me your OTP shared. So all these things they will ask you through your phone. So their convincing power will be too good that you will give away your OTP. And the time you give your OTP, everything will be gone from your account. This can be monetary or any other. So economic effect will be this kind or blackmailing. They have the, I may say that they have the any kind of blackmailing things.
Hello,
sorry, I'm getting in another voice in between. I don't know any other of you are getting.
Yeah, it is. I hope it stopped. You can continue now.
Yeah, thank you. So economic becomes that kind of monetary losses or like blackmailing monetary losses. For example, someone is getting blackmailed or company itself is getting blackmailed from black hat hackers that we have this much of data of yours. If you won't give this much of money or lump sum, we will release this to the public. These kind of blackmailing, this can be anything. It can be data, it can be your photograph, it can be a scammed or like another important documents or like details of yourself. So this can be anything that is meant for like they will blackmail you. You are an individual as in a company, they can blackmail them. This is another kind of economical effect. And another kind of economical effect is like you may have all heard about ransomware, right? They will attack your system. They will they will encrypt all your data and all your whatever there is on your system, and they will demand for a lump sum or a ransom. If you give your ransom, they will give you the decrypted file or the back file to you. So these kind of economical effect will happen to each and everyone or a company or an institution. Anyone can face this. Next thing is psychological. I already said that the harassment and the blackmailing that is getting through online will get you a bad psychological effect, because you may feel like everything is lost, or like all of us have read about almost all the news about the suicides to our teens and school kids. They are doing suicides because they are getting that much of pressure and everything. They are not able to, what we say, face that situation, because they have already a part or a victim of that attack, and they are going through so many tension only because of getting into that. So even then, after they are getting the blackmailed or harassment messages, and if you only do this, we will be kept silent. These kind of harassments will come. So psychological effects is that they, so many studies have clearly stated that this is causing the death, the reason for the death, the depression they are facing. The student, the topmost student who was studying in the class, has for a lot into the last week, only because of this pressure they can't handle. They are facing mentally, everything happens. So psychological things is also a part of the a consequence of a cyber attack. Reputational, even for an individual as well as even for a company, reputational is another kind of loss, because we know that we can take a prominent film artist, right? They are facing each day and every day they are getting attacked, bullied, and they are getting affected to their reputation. Or the company, if they have a data breach, for example, if a financial company, if they had a data breach, they are getting their reputation closed, because no one will go back to their company though their reputation is closed. So even if a hospital, I would say that in a black market or in a deep market, deep internet, the most paid data is the personal health data, not even like anything else, not credit card numbers. No, the most sold data is personal health data. So even if they goes their data breached, that hospital goes its reputation. So everything affects in our reputation. Next is social and societal. The person who has been a victim of the cyber attack is always being going to a psychological. I said that psychological effect is there. But as part of that, the society also becomes the major part of for that person to choose death. Or like, because even if without knowing that, if a photographer or like if an account coming in, I will take my example, my name, even my relative thinks that's me, or like whatever that posted was me. Even if I come with confirmation or explanation, the society won't admit that, okay, this is not her. The society will believe what they have seen first. They will never, even if after saying, or like, even if I have gone to court and I have made my judiciary, or like I have got my, I have proved my innocence, even if after, the society won't believe me. So those kind of societal, we won't be able to face the society, or society won't admit us. And today's society has a very worse case, that without even knowing the sense, they will share the news. Without even thinking twice, they will share it. Even if it is fake, they won't think with their common sense. I will say that. They will never think in their common sense whether this can be a fake news, whether I need to share this. Is it important to share this? No one thinks about it, and they will share immediately. We don't know how many people is getting affected because of that. So this is also happening in this society. So those social kind of and societal effect is also a consequence of cyber attack. So I have already in a way told about this cyber crime. There are lot of types of cyber crime, that is data breach. I already said that even if it is your personal details, it is a data breach. Even if it is anything, we are giving so many personal details for creating an account in a, for example, in a Facebook or like in any other website, we are giving so many personal informations for creating an account, right? And what happens if that organization is getting attacked? All these data will be breached. So we will be giving our mail ID, we will be giving our date of birth, we will be giving our phone number, we will be giving the three security questions, which is usually we use the same questions to all the, hopefully, as I used to, we will be using the same question and answers to almost all the websites we used for sign up. So if an attacker get at least access to one of those attacks, then it is like we are opening all of our details to that attacker. From there, he will chain up his attacks and he will get the access to almost all the accounts of an individual or an organization. So these kind of data breach may happen. For example, if a bank, if the bank has the, what do we say, sensitive data, they are holding the account number, their money itself is held by the bank. If they lost their data, it is like they are losing their entire organization or a company. So these kind of data breaches happens. Next is ransomware. I already said what is a ransomware and how they demand. But we will say that you always need to take care of your data, that you need to daily backup your data. There should be a secondary backup and a tertiary backup. That is like you should daily backup your data, and in a time gap, you should backup in another tertiary private. So, sorry, even if your data is getting attacked by a ransom, if your system is getting, never ever pay the ransom, because you will think that, okay, we can pay for this time. Let us buy this and then patch it. No, once you give the ransom, you become the easily victim of that attacker. You become the easily attacked, because all the ransomwares who encrypts the password will always keep a backdoor in that system. They will never leave their traces from that. They will keep a silent backdoor in that system. Even after the attack, that even if you give that ransom, then again, also you are an easily target for that attacker, because he knows, okay, you are viable for the attack and you are giving the ransom. So never ever entertain such kind of ransomwares. Just backup your data permanently so that even if you are getting attacked, you will get the backup of your data. Next is phishing attacks. This is like a common way from the past 10 years. It's happening. Even today it's happening that you will get a link and you will click on that. You will take to a page which looks similar to the original page. You will enter your data. Then it will show some error and it will redirect to the original page. So you will again enter, you will get signed in. You will never let know that you are hacked or you are phished, or you will never let know. You will be using that site, okay, but the attacker got all the details what he want. So more advanced phishing or like modern phishing attacks includes like you are getting a Word file. Even in that Word file, the macros or like the attachments, malwares can be attached. That becomes a backdoor for the attacker. So all these becomes the modern phishing. I already said that phishing attacks, before that, a successful social engineering will be happened, because the attacker will convince you so that you will click on that link. The pop-ups. Sometimes we are visiting a site. You will get a pop-up. Please click on this. Or like you will get a prominent pop-up, I will say, that attackers uses is Adobe Flash Player update. Usually, I will never say that all the updates for Adobe Flash Player is an attack. But from the hacker perspective, the easily primary pop-up that will work is Adobe Flash Player update. So they will ask for update. No one will go to the direct Adobe site and then install the update. No, no one will. Because we are getting an easy access. Click here. So we are getting an easy access, though immediately we will click on that, right? And we will be taken to some site, and they will ask that for getting this, you need to sign up. We will simply sign up with our username and password. So what we people do, the human, most human error, we will be using the same password for almost all the sites. So we will be giving whatever they required for the attacker. So these kinds of attacks may happen, phishing, right? Let's use malware. The malwares can be like attached to, I already said, it can be attached to what we say, Word file. It can be attached to a Android application or any applications. And if the attacker convinces you to download that and install in your laptop or machine or a phone, then it will be attacked or it will be controlled by a malware. So malwares are a kind of different, maybe different categories. Like some malwares will only take the requested data, but some malwares, they will give the entire access to your phone or your laptop. If I'm saying that it is giving the entire access to your laptop or phone, just imagine if they get the entire access of your phone, what all things a hacker can do? A simple way I will say that a hacker who got the entire access of your phone can operate your front camera and back camera 24/7 without you knowing. Without us, if my phone... Every time wherever we go, this mobile will be in our hand, right? And it will be recording or it will be sharing all these details to the attacker by a way. So it will be access, it will be getting access to all your contacts, all your social media profiles, all your banking structures. Everything is there in your mobile phone. So this thing also can happen. Next is identity theft. Identity theft means, I already said that someone can create a fake profile or like can use someone else's identity for doing an attack. So that is an identity theft. So this happens to so many people because I have seen so many people who has been, chat with the other person without in the online, without knowing the real identity of that person. They will actually, that person will be using the identity of some other person and they will be dealing like that and they will make you convince that, okay, I am this, and they will take whatever they need from you. So those kind of attacks is common today. For example, the teenage girls and teenage boys are more prone to this attack because at this age, they are more inclined or more addicted to Instagram and Facebook. And these attacks are common in Facebook and Instagram. So these kind of attacks are also happening because they will ask your data, pictures and nude pictures, and you will be sharing because once the point has closed and you will be convinced, and if the relation gets stronger, if you share those kind of things, then tomorrow it will be a blackmailing point for everyone. I'm not talking about that. This is only applicable to girls. This is absolutely applicable for boys also, because even if we think, the society thinks, okay, they are boys. No, because once the, I will say that if a small thing has gone to internet, we can never get that back. Once it has gone to internet, it is gone forever. There is no replacement. There is no getting it back. There is no blocking of it. If once a thing is gone to internet, it is gone forever. So even if it is gone, and if it is gone, then if you are, even if we have forget about it, we have gone so much forward in our life. We have got a very good job and we have settled up. Someone someday will bring this up. So it will be always sharpened blade, which can cut you at any time. So when you are dealing internet or when you are dealing a social profile, you should deal it with you should always think that this is going from my hand. If you share one thing, you should always think that, okay, this thing is going from my hand. This is going from my hand and this is going public. There is nothing called a private thing in internet. Everything is public. So whenever you share something, you should always, always think about this. Scams, you can, all kind of scams can come. This time, like every day, we are hearing some kind of scams, right? So we are in a way, or another kind of scams, like for example, you can pay me this much of money, then you will get a kind of, maybe that kind of a business scams can be happen. Like, I won't say, there will be ad like, you will get a lucky ring or lucky pendant, just pay me this much, or you will get this kind, this job, or any kind of scams, even in even all the areas, there are coming kind of frauds or scams are happening day to day life. So we should be aware of whatever we are doing in online or whatever we are sharing in online. We should be always taking care of these kind of things. Or you should think twice. I won't say twice. You should think thrice of or as much as possible time you should take and think, and only then you should act in online. So how to protect yourself against cybercrime? I have said all the things. So how can we, I will never say that if you do all these things, the attack will never happen. No, but we can be precaution, or we can take care of ourselves in a way or other way. So how to protect yourself? Be vigilant about your data you share. I already said this. Be vigilant about what you share in online. Anything, even if you think that you are sharing only, for example, I can say that this is my, what we say, this is like a latest experience or latest complaint or latest thing that I have faced maybe 1 week before I got a complaint. It is like a, from a girl. So she messaged me, ma'am, I need your help because someone has shared my number in a WhatsApp group. And what WhatsApp group? It was a porn group. And that guy shared her number in that porn group. Now she is getting daily bad messages and videos from all over the world, not from a single number, from all over the world. And she's asking, how can I trace this? I said, there is no way to trace it because it's just not coming from a single number to trace it. It is from a multiple numbers. It is coming all the time. So there is no way to track it. I said her, like, immediately block that number and change your number. That is the only way. But you all of us know that it is not an easy way to change our number, right? Because we have us given for so many job purposes, we will be doing, we will be using this number for so many bank transactions, we will be using this number. So our number is a kind of identity ourselves. She has gone her identity, or she need to give her identity back, give away that. So this is the latest thing that happened 1 week before. Before that week, there was another complaint. That is like a small kid. He's only 15 years old. He's a boy. He was chatting with someone in Instagram. And he, the first question from the attacker is, what are you doing? He says that I'm studying. Who all are there in your house? This is a common question, right? Everyone can ask that. So we will be asking, what is the wrong in that? If we are introducing ourselves, we are meeting someone in person, we will ask that, who all are there in your home? So we will simply say that. But an attacker online, if he is aiming at a kid, he will surely think about if there is a circumstances or like its home premise is that he is viable. So, or he is vulnerable. For example, who all are there in yours? He immediately said, me and my mom, my dad is in Gulf. My dad is outside, abroad. Yeah, the attacker got the first instinct. There is a chance this guy is vulnerable, or this kid is vulnerable. And the chat continued. The attacker made him convinced that she is a girl. She is a girl from studying in some 11th or 10th, I think. and she chatted with him, and she built her like the attacker built a relationship with that guy, and the attacker collected all the things he needed required, for example his nude pics, everything, chat screenshots and everything. And then he asked that you should give me the Instagram account of yours, otherwise I will post these photos public. Why he asking this Instagram is like, if you share his Instagram account, the next day he will blackmail for money, and if he won't give, he will post these pics in his own Instagram. That's his plan. But hopefully before he gave that Instagram account, but again before that attack, we blocked it, we recovered that site, we traced that guy, and like this we have blocked this attack. So these kind of change actions is happening. So be vigilant about the data you share. For example, the check-ins. This was a newspaper news. A mother she posted in Facebook that today is my kid's first school, and she had check-in that school, and she have posted her kid's 3 or 4 years kid's photo in the school uniform, and she posted it in the Facebook, and she check-in that school also. Why? How? This is the primarily online cyber attack, but this is a physical attack also. What the attacker people or the kidnapping people do is like, they gone to school, they shown this picture and said that this kid's mom has been hospitalized. Whether going back from here, we need to take the kid as soon as possible, and they took the kid. So we are giving the details for an attack. So every attack begins from us. So we should be aware and vigilant what we share. Next thing is use additional layer of protection. This can be in many ways. That is like for a laptop, we are using an antivirus, right? Of course, it will be a cracked one. Never use a cracked antivirus, because it is like using an antivirus with your own malware. So never use that. Use a proper anti-malware or anti-spyware or an anti-virus. Antivirus, you should use that in your laptop. For a mobile also, I will prefer using some kind of anti-spyware or anti-things. I use in my own phone. So it will be cheap. Like for 1 year, it will be maybe around 400, 700 or 800 for 1 year subscription. So you should use that for mobile. And for all the Google accounts or Facebook accounts, whatever the accounts you are using, you should always use a two-factor authentication. You should add your phone number to it. You should get a OTP. So even if after the attacker is getting your password, he won't be able to log in without that OTP. So always use two-factor authentication. Always protect your accounts using these kind of additional layer of protections. Utilize a password manager. Because why I'm saying is that whenever we have, like, that is a human nature that we will forget some kind. Even if it is we are using the daily, we may have sometimes we will forget it, the password. It is a human nature. So what we will find a way is like, we will use the same password for all the accounts. So it will be easy for us, right? Remembering. So I will say that use a password manager, like CreditPass or like LastPass, one password manager. There are so many password managers. Use a good one, integrate it, save all your passwords, use different passwords for all the accounts, and save this in password manager. And for that password manager, give a master password. Only that should be remembered. In this way, you can manage all your passwords, as well as you can use as what we say, anything, strong passwords with 100 of length you can also use, because it will be integrated in your Chrome, or it will be integrated, it can be downloaded in your phone also. So you will get, or you can copy from the, you can, you will be directly stored that password from the, into the, so it will be easy to manage, and it will be easy. We don't want to think all those things. You can forget what you don't want. All these things, only the master password can be remembered. So this kind of utilize a password manager and be like what we strong ourselves. Otherwise, in a doubt, then block it. No chance for a doubt profile. For example, in a social instance like Facebook or Instagram, you are getting or ad request continuously from a person and you are rejecting it, again it is coming, but you don't know that person, you are having some kind of doubt, then even if it is a small doubt, block that person. Not reject that person or not unfriend that person. Just block that person. Inner doubt. I will never say that you have a surety. Inner doubt, if you have even a doubt instinct, just block that person. Not like, okay, I haven't added this person. No, not like that. Just block that. So inner doubt, block. Avoid unwanted clicks. This is like I'm telling about the phishing. This is like whatever things, if you think like this is not required for me, this is not a proper URL or this is an unwanted URL, never click on that. Never click on an unwanted adware. Never click on an unwanted news. For example, prominent, I doubt that I should say that this is in Malayalam. ഫേസ്ബുക്കിൽ നമ്മൾ സ്ഥിരം കാണാറുള്ളതാണ് നടിക്ക് സംഭവിച്ചത് എന്തെന്ന് അറിഞ്ഞാൽ നിങ്ങൾ ഞെട്ടും. പ്ലീസ് ക്ലിക്ക് ഹിയർ ടു ഓപ്പൺ ദിസ് യു ആർ എൽ. ദിസ് ഇസ് ലൈക്ക് എ ഫണ്ണി തിങ് ദാറ്റ് ഹാസ് ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ, ഈവൻ മൈ മോം ക്ലിക്സ് ഓൺ ദാറ്റ്. ഐ ഡോണ്ട് നോ വൈ ഷീ ഈസ് ദിസ് മച്ച്. മൈ മോം ഇസ് എ ഫേസ്ബുക്ക് യൂസർ ആൻഡ് ഷീ യൂസ് ടു ക്ലിക്ക് ഓൺ ദി തിങ്സ് ലൈക്ക് ഓക്കെ ഇഫ് യു ഷെയർ ദിസ് യു വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ലക്കി ഇൻ 5 days. ഈവൻ ഇഫ് ഐ സേ 100 ടൈംസ് ഷീ വിൽ സേ ദാറ്റ് നോ 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 ദർ ഇസ് എ ചാൻസ്. So these things can happen. So please don't click just like that. So please don't click on the unwanted URLs or unwanted post. Just avoid that. Never click. And the last and final is raise your voice. Even if we do whatever the precautions, even if you take whatever the precautions, even if we have done all the anti-spyware, still there is a chance of attack. Still there is a chance that we can become a victim. If you have faced any attack, if you have been, raise your voice to the concerned departments. There is CyberCell, active CyberCell. You should go there. You should complain. If you are saying that I don't want to give my identity or reveal my identity, then also they will support you. They will never make that public. They will do the investigation in a silent mode. They will help you in whatever way they can. So, but all you should is like, you should raise your voice. Never be silent. You should raise your voice at appropriate time, in a proper manner. You should raise your voice. When you become silent, the attacker becomes more confident. When you become silent, the attacker attacks some other person. When you become silent, all other people like you are getting attacked. So you raise your voice, raise that at the proper time. I will say if it is kids, never think that my parents will abuse me, or like my parents will leave me or nothing like that. Everything, maybe there will be a beginning shock for them also, but later they will be the only one supporting you. The parents will be the only one standing side by you. So you should speak to them. You should tell them that I have faced this much of harassment, or I am facing this harassment. I can't take this much more. So I should complain this. So raise your voice at a proper time. This is it. I have gone out of my time, I know. I know this is a more generalized way. I haven't gone any of there in a technical way, because the time restrictions is everything is happening there. So I hope at least some of you have understood or like got the idea of cybercrime and how it is happening to us. So thank you so much for hearing to me for the past 45 minutes. If any doubts, just let me know. I can help you with that. If I know.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. So guys, if you have any doubt, do put that in the chat box. We'll be addressing that now. Anyone, any doubts? Or any queries or anything to ask to the ma'am here?
Ma'am, I have a doubt. As parents, What are precautions should we take? Because all our kids are always sitting in front of these gadgets now, and always we won't be able to peep into it.
That's a very good question, ma'am. Actually, I appreciate it because I am also a mother of two kids. Even they are only six, I know that their screen time is like, even I have like go to so many stages and say that, but even in my home, my kids are like, their screen time is like nearly 4 to 5 hours a day, because even their classes has become online. So I don't have any way to avoid that also. But I have found my own way. How can I do that? Plus, I have done a family link in their phone. They are using their tab for it. So I have done a family link. So I have signed up their mobile phone in another email ID. And there is a Google family link application. I have downloaded that in the family link for teens and students. I have downloaded in their mobile phone. There is a family link for parents in our mobile phone. Under our mail ID, we can add their mail ID as a, what we say, controller or a parental control thing. In that, we can manage everything, their screen time. For example, they are watching YouTube. We can set their screen time, like they can only watch YouTube for 1 hour a day. If we set that after 1 hour, the YouTube won't work in their phone. These kind of controls is there. We can control their Play Store. If in my kids' Play Store, I have said that Google Play Store, that it should be 3+. So whatever in between 3 to 6 years will be only visible to them in Play Store, in their search. Other than everything, it will be blocked, automatically blocked by Google. So this can be done for your kids.
Thank you, ma'am. So guys, any other question to ask? I hope there is nothing more to address.
Thank you.
Ma'am, thank you so much. Actually, I didn't even, not only me, but most of the people who are here mustn't even know that there is so easy to get our phone hacked or to be accessing our phone or lab. Yeah, it did scare us a bit in the beginning, but thank you so much for showing there are so other methods also.
Thank you,
ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for gracing your important works and sharing your thoughts and opinions with us today. Thank you so much for all the wonderful knowledge and insight you shared with our youths in this session. Thank you.